everybody. This is day 4 of Commit, 30 days of yoga, where we will be working towards opening and strengthening our hips. It's said in yoga, happy hips, happy heart, or that finding harmony in the hips leads to harmony in the entire body. And with our hips affecting the way that we move, walk, sit, or even sleep, it's easy to see why. Please give this video a like and remember to subscribe. Feel free to leave me a comment down below and stick around to the end of the video where we explore one of the movements from today's practice.
Let's begin standing in mountain pose. Step your feet to a wide stance, toes slightly turned out. Inhale, arms up. Let's move through goddess pulses. Exhale down, inhale up. Last one, hold goddess pose. And return to standing. Turn your toes to face forward, widening your stance more if you like. Clasp your hands ahead of you as we move through static side-to-side lunges with a pulse. Each side. Two more. Last set. To standing. Hands to your hips. Send your seat back. Let's fold forward, keeping your back straight for as long as you can, and then placing your hands down on the mat. It's okay to round out a bit once you've touched down. Try if you can to line the heels of your hands up with the heels of your feet. Taking your hands back to your hips, tighten up the legs and return to standing, flat back. Take your arms out to your sides at shoulder height, lengthening the spine in a five-pointed star pose. Rotate to the right in a crescent lunge, arms up, back heel lifted. chest lifted, shoulders down and back. Check to make sure your front knee is pointing in the same direction as your toes and not turning. Hips are level with each other. As your back foot points to the side, see if you can connect to the outer edge of that back foot. Avoid leaning the body forward or back. Gaze over the middle finger of your right foot. Side or up towards your left hand. Lower the top hand, placing your hands on either side of that front foot, folding over the leg in a pyramid pose. A slight bend in the knee is okay. The back knee, engage the legs and lift the arms to a low lunge. Lower both hands to the inside edge of that front foot to a lizard pose. If you can, you can lower to one or both forearms. Raise the right arm up high as you drop the right knee out to the side, turning onto the outer edge of the foot. If you can, raise the back foot and grasp it with the right hand to a lizard twist. Quad stretch. Side lunge and spin dasana pose. You can keep the hands down here if you prefer or take them to heart center. Let's shift over to the left side now. Free or with your hands down to a low lunge pose on the left side, take the arms up. both hands to the inner edge of the front foot to a lizard pose. Option to lower to one or both forearms. To the hands, raise the left arm up. Option to move to a quad stretch, grasping the back foot, dropping the left knee. And make your way to low lunge, arms up. Hands down to either side of the front foot. Raise the back knee, straightening the legs as you fold in pyramid pose. Turn the back foot out, left hand to your shin or inner edge of the front foot, shifting to a triangle pose. Bend that front knee and transition to a warrior two. Chest up, shoulders down, reach long through both arms. Rotate to a crescent lunge, arms up, back toes turned forward with the heel raised. Turning to the long edge of your mat, wide stance, arms wide to a five-pointed star pose. Walk the feet in to hip distance apart. Take the right leg up and place it over the left, bending the left knee to a standing pigeon pose. Hands can stay on the leg or you can take them together. Release and shift over to the opposite side. Thank you. and release to mountain pose, taking a breath. Shift your weight to the left, picking up the right foot, holding the foot or the big toe, stand up tall. Let's extend out to the side to a big toe hold pose. With control. Shift your weight to the right side, pick up the left foot, and stand up tall before extending. Step your feet just wider than shoulder width apart, toes turned slightly out. Let's lower to a garland pose, palms together. Press your arms into your legs, legs back into your arms. Get long through the back and neck, taking your breath. Transitioning to a hero pose, option to sit on your heels instead. For hero pose, let's bring our knees together and aim to sit between our feet. An internal rotation at the hips. Sit up tall, hands in your lap. Hands down ahead of you, let's take those knees apart, then feet apart to a frog stretch. You can come onto your forearms if you like. We're lining up our feet behind our knees and keeping the hips in line with the knees without leaning them forward or back. Release, feet together, knees together, make your way to kneeling for camel pose. Option to curl the toes under to bring your heels closer to your hands, or stay down on the tops of the feet. Take your hands to your lower back for support and begin to bend back, pressing the hips forward to keep them lined up over the knees. Stay here, or take one hand, then the other, back to your heels for camel pose, arching the back, squeezing the glutes, opening the chest, and gazing up or back. gazing forward, return your hands to your lower back to straighten up. Hands down, let's draw that right knee forward to a pigeon stretch. Right foot ahead of the left hip. Let's make sure that our hips are squared off to the mat. Get long through the back before folding over that front leg. Press back to table pose, then bring that left knee forward to pigeon pose on the opposite side. Make sure your right toes are pointing straight back and not turning in. Get long through the back before folding over that front leg. This time, also raising the chest and arms to a locust pose. And lower. Send your left arm out to the side at shoulder level. Step your right foot back and behind the left leg to an open wing pose. Keeping the right hand. Release onto your belly. Right arm out to the side this time. Step the left foot over and back to open wing pose on the opposite side. knees onto your belly and press up to table, knees wide, toes together. Lean back to a wide knee child's pose. Hips over heels, try to relax the lower back. Making your way to seated. Take the soles of the feet together in a bound angle position. Loosen up the legs and hips with small pulses. Draw the knees down, sitting up tall. Legs out to a seated wide angle position, taking your time to shift your hips as needed. Place your hands down ahead of you. You can stay here or option to lower to your forearms if you can. Seated, bend the left knee in. Shift to the right, reaching for the right foot with right hand. Left arm stretches up and over. Reach long through the left hand, or if you can, grab the right toes. Position in a hurdler stretch. Square your shoulders off to the right foot and fold forward over that right leg, reaching towards the ankle, foot, or toes. Let's switch the legs, extending the left, bending the right leg in. Shift to the left, right arm stretches up and over. Seated, flip the right leg to a hurdler stretch. square the shoulders off to the left foot and fold over the left leg. Back to seated with both legs extended ahead of you now. Draw the left leg in and place the left foot over the right leg to the outer edge of the right thigh. Right arm up, twist, placing the arm to the outer edge of the left leg. Arm bent, hand open, sit up tall and gaze back. The twist and switch legs. Right foot over the left leg, left arm to the outer edge of the right leg. Gaze back. Release the twist and make your way onto your back, knees bent. Place the left ankle over the right leg. Draw the right leg in towards your chest to a reclined pigeon stretch. And repeat that on the opposite side. Feet down, arms at your sides. Raise your hips to a bridge pose. Option to take your hands to your lower back to press the hips up higher in a supported bridge pose. Thank you. your hips and draw your legs in towards your chest, grasping onto the feet in a happy baby pose. You can hold the inner edges of the feet, hold onto the toes, or hold the outer edges of the feet. The soles of the feet should be pointing straight up to the sky as your knees press down at the sides of your body. Lower your feet to the mat, hands on your belly, take the soles of the feet together and drop the knees out wide to a reclined bound angle position. Pay attention to your breath, feeling the rise and fall of your belly to finish up.
And if you find that very uncomfortable, one way that you can modify is taking a blanket, a cushion, or a rolled up yoga mat and placing that beneath your heels. So that gives you lots of support and allows you to focus more on that alignment throughout the rest of the body. And you'll notice here I even brought my feet in closer together because that's just where I felt that it was most comfortable. And you're free to do that. If you're in a yoga class and you don't have an extra mat, or any props that can do that for you, you can always roll up the back edge of the mat that you're working on and then use that for a little bit more support. Another thing that you can do to modify is to sit on a block. if you're really high up and you're lacking a lot of mobility, you might sit on the block in this position, and then with time, as that mobility improves, you might be lowering the block more and more to suit where you're at. And so again, you're just resting on the block, which allows you to sit up tall, open up, and focus on alignment, focus on your breath, without worrying about balance or about any pain that you don't want to feel. Cushions, meditation cushions, pillows, bolsters work just as well as the block. Sometimes they can even be a little bit more comfortable if you feel like you're going to be settling in garlic pillows for even longer. And then from here, once we have our garlic pillows, something that you can do to advance it is to start to bring your feet a little bit closer together with time as your dorsiflexion improves, unless that causes pain in the arches or anywhere. Otherwise, stay where you're at. But we can draw the feet closer together, again, trying to ground through the heels, and then keep that same alignment where we're straight through the back, the neck follows, ears are up and away from the